Let's say someone walks up to you on the street and says to you, 50 divided by 5, 50 divided by 5 is equal to blank, is equal to blank. How can you think about this as a multiplication problem? Well, whatever blank is, if you multiply by 5, you should get 50. So one way of thinking about it, you could say, what times 5 is 50? Well, 10 times 5 is 50. 10 times 5 is 50, so 50 divided by 5 is going to be 10. Hopefully you see the relationship here. 50 divided by 5 is 10, then 10 times 5 is 50. 10 times 5 is 50. And you could do it the other way around. What is 50 divided by 10 going to be? 50 divided by 10, well, that's going to be equal to 5. 50 divided by 10 is going to be equal to 5. How do I know that? Well, 5 times 10 is equal to 50, is equal to 50. So let's keep thinking about this. If someone walked up to the street again and said blank, blank, divided by 2, blank divided by 2 is equal to 9, how would you figure out what blank is? Something divided by 2 is equal to 9. Well, one way to think about it, and if we just follow here, if you said 50 divided by 5 is 10, you could say 10 times 5 is 50. So right over here, we could say, well, 9 times 2 must be equal to blank, must be equal to our blank. Well, we know what 9 times 2 is, that is 18. So this must be 18. 18 divided by 2 is 9. And that's really describing how 18, 2, and 9 relate to each other. 2 9s is 18, or 9 2s is 18. Or if I were to divide 18 into 2 groups, each group would have 9. Or if I were to divide into groups of 2, you would have 9 groups. Any way you look at it, 18 divided by 2 is 9. 9 times 2 is 18. Let's do one more of these. So someone walks up to you on the street and tells you that 12 divided by blank is equal to 3, is equal to 3. What is blank going to be? Well, one way to think about this is 3 times blank is going to be equal to 12. 3 times blank, 3 times this unknown number is going to be equal to 12. And 3 times what is equal to 12? Well, 3 times 4 is equal to 12. So 12 divided by 4 is equal to 3.